Welcome to match two of Hardened Scales. We just took down Tron in a game where we got really, really lucky that they didn't ever assemble Tron. that was pretty good. Those are the slowest Tron player I ever saw in terms of like assembling Tron. This hand just does nothing at all. I mean, it does have stirrings. So I get stirrings up. Now I can stirrings on turn one, find a good two drop, play it on turn two with a welding jar. Stirrings on turn three to find another good two drop, play that. All right, I've talked myself into keeping it. Quite mediocre though. Blue white control, not great. Hangerback Walker looks the best against that. Actually, Path to Exile is a thing. I should be worried about Path. Because I'm worried about Path, I should be playing Throne of Geth next turn. Oh no. The Spreading Seas. I am so sad. Yeah, I'm gonna play the Throne of Geth so that, If when he paths my hanger back, I can sacrifice it in response to still get the counter. I suppose like me getting a land is not the end of the world, but I do have a lot of land, so I don't really need more. Top bottom. Let's see if he actually makes a land drop or if he's mono screwed. Okay, he does have planes. Hangerback's kind of nice. I'm gonna do a stirrings. See if I find something I'd rather play than the hangerback. I'll take an overseer. This way I can play two hangerbacks next turn. That seems pretty good. This is probably getting pathed. Sure. I'm fine with this. Ooh, that was a punt. I should have activated it and sacrificed it to Throne of Geth just to keep him off lands. Actually, I mean, it's not a huge punt though, because this way I get to keep up Throne of Geth anyways. Where if I... That's disgusting. Damn. I really wanted to have Throne of Geth and two things so I could proliferate. Damn. Suddenly got a lot worse. So definitely want a hanger back. Do I keep the hanger back alive? I think keeping the hanger back alive for this turn seems pretty good. Oh, did I just get baited super hard? Yeah, I did. Ouch. I was like, yeah, he can't path it. Man, wrecked. I could play the Starrings, but I know I'm going to get the hanger back next turn, so I'm going to save it to hit a good card on the turn afterwards. Screw you and your cards. This now because it does open me up to path, but it doesn't let me get counterspelled by like a cryptic. Colonnade. All right, I can beat Colonnade beats. Overseer, I like this. All right, let's get rid of Stirrings. Ravager. All right. I can work with this. Suppose I should have played Ravager first. Oh well. Oh, this is a counterspell. Yeah, I really should have played Ravager first. Oh well. Right, so he's empty-handed. I have a significantly better board position. His top decks are probably on average a bit more powerful than mine, but mine are actually have the potential to be pretty insane. Like if I draw a Hardened Scales, it's better than anything he could draw, pretty much. Except for, I suppose, like Sphinx's Rev. Certainly, anything I can do is better than a Celestial Colonnade beat. Due to my general lack of artifacts, I'm going to avoid proliferating this turn. I could proliferate to seven. I don't really need to. Actually, no, that is better. So I still have the sacrifice outlet of Ravager left. Excellent, excellent. What do we want? What do we want? Definitely want animation module. Definitely want some nature's claims. I'll take out the Rishkar. Do actually think I'll take out some Thrones of Geth. I think I can shave a land or two. Maybe two is ambitious. Do I want Shaper Sanctuary? He's got some spot removal, but not a ton. Take an opal for Shaper Sanctuary. All right, see how this goes. Shaper Sanctuary is much better against like Mardu, Jund, Hollow One. All right, well, we got some things. Like, this matchup is long enough that I'm not too worried about just dying before I can cast my spells. Alright, alright. Go away. Thank you. Because, like, sure, I'm missing my land drops, but I'm not about to lose because of it. Sure. Spreading Seas my forest. I do actually need to hit my land drops at some point, so maybe I'll be slightly embarrassed by taking out my my lands. For the record, this could have been a Mox Opal. Rejection on the module. Fair enough, fair enough. Ooh. Jace is not good for me. Is he just gonna try to screw me off lands? Yep. Alright, well, I got an Arcbound worker, ha. Looks like I'm not drawing a land next turn. Well, at least I'll draw Stirrings. And then I'm going to redraw my... Oh. Okay. I guess I'm going to play Overseer. Do really gotta kill this Jace. Bottom's my worker. And Stirrings. Alright, well, I need to hit my land drops, so I'm gonna Stirrings. Ooh, a Pendlehaven. Strictly better than a forest. Ish. Get an Overseer. Sure. I'm really glad this deck has so many basics. One problem you're not going to have is running out of basics. Topping a what? A Mox Opal? Alright, well, I'm gonna cast a bunch of spells this turn then. Play the Throne of Geth so that I can sacrifice it in response if I need to, and then I'll play the Hangerback Walker. Then I'll play the Ravager. I think we might have this. There's not a whole lot of things he can do to stop us from stopping Jace from ulting, and he's kind of low on cards because he's been plus plus plussing instead of drawing. I'm gonna draw my card. And then I suppose I'm gonna sacrifice it because I don't really need another land at this point. Make Hangerback Walker a little bit bigger. Does our opponent finally brainstorm? Nope. Alright. It's his call. Time to attack Jace. Cryptic tap. Tap and draw. Yep. That's a thing. Oh, I should do this. That's what it is I'm supposed to do. And then I'm supposed to Mocking Ballista. Hope he hasn't drawn a counterspell. Did he really draw into a counterspell? Oh, no, he didn't. This is somewhat risky. Jace does not ult this turn. I did that kind of wrong. Wow, this is awful. I guess I take a Citadel? At least I bottomed a whole bunch of garbage. Yeah, I really should have held up the Throne of Geth by Legend ruling the Mox Opal. That was a bit sloppy. I was like, oh yeah, I don't wanna Legend rule the Mox Opal when I could Throne of Geth. Oh, he finally brainstorms. I guess he's like, oh shit. After my long quest to ult Jace, I realize that I can't. Fortunately, even if he has a path, at least I get to draw a card. Also, he's used, what, two paths and an oust? It's irritating. Colonnade's not really a big deal. Certainly gonna hit Jace. Could really use what? Nissa? Walking Ballista is not bad. Cannot kill Jace this turn. So this actually does get kind of awkward if he's got another Wrath. Is he like, someday I'm gonna run him out of basics? Okay. Sure. I think this is the definition of spinning your wheels. Oh, here's... No, Gideon. Gideon's a thing. Thank you for the card. Oh, it's Stirrings. That's quite good, actually. I can just do my Ballista-ing on upkeep. On his upkeep. Get a welding jar. The overseer. All of these cards attack Jace. Man, we've seen most of our deck and have not gotten a, what do you call it? Hardened Scales. I should really have put the +1/+1 counter on it. No, I don't want it. I want it to go to Jace. Whoops. I did that wrong. Oh well. One damage to Gideon is not going to hurt me. Not to Gideon, yes to Jace. Alright, there we go. A new Jace. Alright, sure. Strand, fetch away whatever you brainstormed, and what do we have? More spinning of wheels. Visions, bottom. Visions. Doesn't have the mana to wrath anymore, so there's that. Bottom again. Sure, Gideon, you can do that. I'll just add another counter to my ballista. Scales. I suppose that's pretty good too. See a good reason not to proliferate. Let's see, now what? So I'd send a Thopter at that, a Thopter at that, two Thopters in the ballista at him. If he deals with either of the Thopters, then I take counters. Jace, Gideon, him, alright. We got him, Gideon, Jace, and him. Oh, sweet. You can see this deck is much better set up to kind of like grind through this sort of garbage than regular Affinity is. The bigger weakness of this compared to regular Affinity is much, much weaker sideboard cards. Anyways, see you for the next match.